came by the house wearing all black. Black shoes, suits, ties, as if they were the ones who had to attend his funeral. They took a moment to mumble amongst themselves before finally knocking, and my mom, she gave me this look. A look of absolute fear, unadulterated fear, because she knew what those men would be telling us long before neither me nor my sister clued in. What I'd been fearing would happen to him since I was old enough to process what he actually did for a living. It was a landmine. And of course, the men were just so sorry for our loss. Sure. Sure, your bloody story. That's why you let the media harass our family for the next year. His face on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, you name it. There's no moving on or escaping it. No privacy in releasing his name. And everyone is just so incomprehensibly nice when someone dies. It's fake as hell. And it eventually, that false sense of support, stops. Making you feel an infinite times worse than you did before. His death had inevitably occurred. And what I still can't quite comprehend is why on earth it had happened to him. He was just intelligence. This crap isn't... wasn't supposed to happen to him. He's gone just 3 months. 3 of the 6 required. My little sister isn't the same. My mom isn't the same. I'm the only one in this broken family who's tried not to change. Probably because I'm the only one who knows a vague concept on how to live without him. He was gone so much from the start of my life anyways with this military idiocy. Can't name a birthday he was home for until I was 9. There's no difference having him dead. No, I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean that. He never realized how much my mom and Rachel needed him. And now he never will. And I guess what I realized is you can't rely on anyone. Everyone will always let you down. And now I'm the one to support the family. The one to stay strong. The one to say I'm fine when anyone asks, because that's just my job. Being fine. Just fine. And I am. What's wrong with me this time? What's wrong with me this time? I want to be alone. I can't be around other people. I can't even go to school anymore without breaking down. The people. They just scare me. Sometimes I get so scared that I feel like I can't even breathe. I just need to be alone. I bet you don't even care. You're just helping me because it's your job, right? Oh, and once I'm better and not crazy anymore, you'll just move on to another patient, right? You're just like everyone else. Mom, Dad, everyone. No one cares about me anymore, and I'm sick of people pretending they do. You can't care about me, because that would be unprofessional, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. Oh, please do. But I'll say it again. You don't care. That would be a burden you don't need. For all I know, you probably haven't cared about anyone in years, and I know myself better than you do. I need to be let out. You're not God. I know what you can and can't do, and what you can't do is help me. That's why they put me in here. Let me out! Let me go! You think you can help me? Change me? You're like the glass at the store that you break and are forced to buy. You don't want to, but you have to. You're helping me because you have to, because it's your job. But I'm too broken for you to fix. So you might as well let me out now before I fix this myself.
I still remember that day. The day it happened. The day everything changed for me. I've heard of things like this happening in movies and such. But I never thought it would actually happen to me. to her. I was 11 at the time. I still remember the last time I saw her. The last time I heard her voice. We were fighting about something stupid. My grades, I think. Kids were mean. I never could focus on my work. That's why I wasn't doing too well. But the last things we said were so mean, so wrong. I thought if I could just get through the day, we would make up at the end like always. But it wasn't like that. Little did I know that my mother was tired of life. She didn't see the point. Little did I know that would be the last morning I spent with my mom. She was so young, so beautiful, so perfect. Never thought she would be the one to go. It was so unreal to me. It all happened so fast. But once I understood, I felt like all I could do was cry. This was going to haunt me. Now it's 5 years later, and I still can't help thinking, what if I did things differently? Ugh. If I had taken 2 minutes to try and calm down and be reasonable, this never would have happened. My mom would still be with me. Maybe it's not my fault. I mean, I'm not the one who took the life away from her. Why did you do this to me? Why did you take the only mother I ever had away? She was my best friend. One who really understood me. She made me feel like being different wasn't so bad. Like I had a worth and a purpose. She was the only person who mattered on this damn earth, so why did you take her? I'm so lost without her. Who am I anymore?